Michael Jordan was royalty. He was Elvis Presley. He was the Beatles. It was Michael Jordan versus the NBA. He was that good. And he had a charisma that was unique to him, but also that killer instinct of wanting to win. When Michael Jordan came into town, the Great Western Forum became the place to be. You couldn't live your life if you didn't get a chance to see Michael Jordan perform in person. When the Lakers and the Bulls faced each other in that 1991 finals, it was that moment where you could really say sports and entertainment were coming together. When the Bulls won that series, you know, right there you saw like kind of the passing of the torch. You know, what Michael did and what Michael accomplished and represented in the 90s inspired the next generation of talent. Michael Jordan is the greatest of all time.
Just up the 110 freeway from the Great Western Forum, the glistening L.A. skyline. One of the storylines today, two of the Lakers starters, James Worthy and Byron Scott, injured and unable to play. And we're coming to you live from Inglewood, California. This is Game 5 of the 1991 NBA Final. The Chicago Bulls lead the L.A. Lakers 3-1. Hi, everyone. Kevin Harlan joined by Coach Mike Fratello, Clark Kellogg, and we'll hear from our reporter David Aldridge in a few moments. Ike, the key to the Bulls' Game 4 win, which we saw a couple days ago, was defense.
The key being that they held the Lakers to 37% shooting, Kev. Michael Jordan, Scottie Pippen, both guarding Magic Johnson, picking him up full court, making things difficult for the Magic Man.
It was a clinic. And in Game 4, on the offensive end, Clark, another stellar performance from Michael Jordan.
Hey, look, Kevin, we've come to expect 28 points or more from Jordan on a regular basis, but the 13 assists show how much Jordan's game has grown. Not trying to do it all himself, trusting his teammates. Now just one win away from an elusive first NBA championship for Michael Jordan.
Boy, that's a great point about Jordan's playmaking. Well said. And now a look at the Chicago Bulls. The MVP, Michael Jordan, is in the backcourt, joined by sharpshooting John Paxson. Chicago's defensive stopper, Scottie Pippen, is in the small forward. Horace Grant is at the four. And the experienced veteran, Bill Cartwright, is at the center. And for the Lakers, Magic Johnson runs showtime. Terry Teagle and A.C. Green are in the lineup, both injury replacements. Sam Perkins at the four can really shoot it. And Vlade Divac, the young, skilled five.
The Lakers missing two starters, Byron Scott and James Worthy. They'll really rely heavily on two rookies, Tony Smith and Eldon Campbell.
The feed to Divac. Shot clock at six. Scottie Pippen grabs the miss.
That's not a bad look. He missed that chance, but he'll get them to fall if he gets space like that.
And slam dunk by Jordan.
Jordan's got a lot of flash to his game. A terrific guard, loves getting tricky with his ball handling and creating shots for himself.
And Clark, for L.A., A.C. Green is going to have to be a very big part of their attack tonight.
Kevin, averaging just 4 points a game in these finals, A.C. was huge when the Lakers beat Portland in the Western Conference Finals. Brought a ton of energy. I think the Lakers need that version of him tonight.
Oh, I would agree. First quarter of play, 1 minute played. So far, Clark, the leader in assists in the finals, not Magic Johnson. It's Michael Jordan facilitating.
How about that, partner? I mean, he's been incredible, averaging about 12 assists per game. He's also been the leading scorer in each game as well. That's otherworld-like production.
Good here. Johnson against Jordan. Johnson inside. Here's Teagle, guarded by Paxson. And the Lakers with another miss. And here are the Bulls now. The Bulls looking to close this series out and off to a hot start.
The other Bulls starting guard, John Paxson, just tremendous in this series thus far, shooting 62%.
Paxson is a knockdown shooter. Michael Jordan gets so much attention, that allows Paxson to get open looks. And he's been drilling them.
Knocking them down.
Puts up a three. And the Lakers with another miss. It's been a quick start here for Chicago. 6-point game. Here's Jordan. In this closeout game, Michael Jordan is off to a quick start.
I've got Michael Jordan on the injury watch list tonight. He's got a jammed toe. It's badly bruised, and you know how painful those can be, Coach. Extremely difficult to play through that kind of an injury.
After playing through that toe injury in Game 4, Michael told us it didn't bother him then, and it won't bother him now. I think Jordan will be A-OK tonight.
And the Lakers have had some tough luck with injuries so far, especially in Game 4. For more, let's go to David Aldridge.
Well, guys, the Lakers will be without their all-star forward, James Worthy, and their starting shooting guard, Byron Scott. Worthy, of course, suffered a badly sprained ankle in the Western Conference Finals and re-aggravated it in Game 4 of this series. And Scott went down with a shoulder injury in the same game. It's going to take a group effort to make up for those absences. Guys?
Well put, D.A. Both Worthy and Scott are crucial, Mike, to this Lakers offense.
And not only their offense, those two guys have alternated guarding Jordan throughout the series. Without them, the Lakers have limited options defensively.
Mike, remember in Game 4, the last timeout, the Lakers shot just 37% from the floor.
Scottie Pippen and Michael Jordan were monsters on the defensive end. Magic and the Lakers will need to execute better to have a shot tonight.
37% just is not going to get it done.
The fact that Chicago has had Michael Jordan and Scottie Pippen take turns defending Magic Johnson has really served the Bulls well. They've been able to pick up the Magic man full court and have caused him to expend a lot of energy trying to get the Lakers into their offense.
And Chicago's looking to tire out Magic, make him work bringing the ball up the court. Pippen and Jordan have done an outstanding job in executing that game plan. The blend of athleticism and scoring prowess Jordan possesses is insane. He's capable of destroying teams all by himself.
Looking at who's out there now for the Lakers. Campbell is checked in for Perkins. And Smith subbed in for Teagle. Johnson kicks to Smith. Not really his range, and it's off target. And here are the Bulls now. They're on a 12-4 run right now. Yep, that one goes in there.
They could not have asked for a better start.
This is looking like a no contest already.
Game one of the finals, a Bulls loss, 18 combined points for Paxson, Bill Cartwright, Horace Grant. Games two through four, Mike, those three averaging 42 points a game.
That trio, the other Bulls starters, their success is essential for Chicago. The Bulls need scoring outside of Pippen and Jordan.
Clearly proven.
Jordan is smelling blood in the water, looking to end the series tonight.
Smith kicks to Green. Trying to find Johnson. He's got it now. Pass to Smith. Back to Johnson. Another shot. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line. It's going to be on Michael Jordan.
Look at Magic going fishing for the foul, baiting the defender with the pump fake.
Williams is checked in for the ball.
Free throw shooting is a skill, and this guy absolutely has it.
Here's Jordan. Michael Jordan can taste that first title, and he wants to end it tonight.
Their scoring has been a problem, been tough to handle.
And it's enabled them to establish a substantial lead in the early going. Guys, this is hard to believe, but dating back to last year's series with Detroit, the Lakers have lost four straight finals games at home.
That is hard to believe. That is shocking, that little factoid there, Mike. It used to feel like it was impossible to win in this building. Not so the case anymore.
Jordan with the bucket.
They've been the aggressors right from the start, asserting themselves from the very beginning.
Yeah, they're setting the tone, and they're doing it on both ends of the floor.
6-second difference between the shot and game clock. They double-team defense. Green with a screen for Smith. Johnson outside. Divac trying to free himself up. And just like in game four, the Lakers struggling from the field.
The defensive duo of Jordan and Pippen. Their athleticism is causing major issues for the Lakers.
And so it's the Chicago Bulls enjoying a 12-point lead as they talk things over during the break.
The Bulls.
Second quarter here in the 1991 NBA Finals, Game 5 with Mike Clark, T.A. This is Kevin Harlan. Michael Jordan and the Bulls trying to close it out tonight.
The leading scorer in each of the first four games of this series? Yeah, you guessed it, Michael Jordan. In the regular season, MJ led the NBA in scoring for the fifth straight year. Jordan cannot be stopped in this series.
They've got Campbell. Smith is out there with Johnson. Then it's Green, and it's Perkins in at the four spot. That's the group for the Lakers to start the second quarter. Smith feeling it out a bit and stolen by Jordan.
Not sure what he was thinking with that pass. The defense reading it well and pouncing all over. And the speed and quickness of the Bulls is a clear advantage. As this series has developed, we've seen Chicago have success pushing the tempo.
And for Jordan Clark, it's not just scoring in these finals.
It sure isn't, Kevin. He's averaging almost 12 assists per game, in addition to his usual spectacular defense. And with a closeout game on the line, I expect a monster performance from Michael Jordan. And if the Bulls win, he will clearly be your finals MVP.
Lakers trail by 16. The Lakers pour from the field. And Clark, that has to change as this game goes on.
Well, to me, it appears the Lakers have no answer, Kevin, for the defensive duo and prowess of Pippen and Jordan. These two Bulls are creating havoc.
Here's Jordan. And in this potential clincher, Jordan's so good at the start and looking for more.
And right now, MJ has it going on. His teammates should just continue to get him the rock.
Johnson kicks to Smith. Second quarter of basketball, just over a minute and a half played so far. Perkins, the rebound by Cartwright. Cartwright's got his fifth rebound right now in the game. Some nice ball movement here by the Bull. Lakers with the rebound. Johnson surveying the floor. Basket counts. Johnson's got 8 points.
Nice execution by Magic. I like how he focuses on taking high percentage shots.
Well, the matchup of the series, Mike, as we see two-time MVP Michael Jordan going up against three-time MVP Magic Johnson. Again, as we can see, it's advantage MJ.
The Bulls star has won that battle all series long. A huge reason the Bulls were in position to win the title tonight.
And it has been entertaining. Remember, Chicago and LA, two very different, distinct franchises, Mike.
This is the Lakers. 9th trip to the finals since 1980. They're used to being here. For Chicago, this is their first ever trip to the finals.
Los Angeles making a switch here. Teagle's checked in. And the Bulls making a change here as well. Grant's checked in. Jordan, the pass to Grant. And here is Cartwright. Good, and it's Jordan picking up the assist. And the Bulls lead by 18.
Boy, Cartwright doing a nice job there, finishing through the hit. Persistence paying off.
Let's hear from David Aldridge on the sideline.
Thank you, Kevin. Now, the marquee matchup of Magic versus Michael has not disappointed. But what's surprising is that Jordan's actually averaging more assists than the assist king. Coming into this game, Jordan is averaging 11.8 assists per game compared to Magic's 10.5. Kevin, back to you.
DA, astounding numbers. Thanks for that report. And both stars, Clark, have played nearly every minute of this series. I mean, they've gone nonstop.
Well, that's not surprising, Kevin. This is it. There's no time to rest. I mean, both guys know exactly how important each game is in this series, and that's why they're averaging the minutes they are, about 44 per game.
You know, carrying that kind of load on both of their shoulders, you would think, my gosh, will they be brought down by the weight of that? Not these guys. They thrive in these situations, don't they?
They really relish opportunities like this to compete at the highest level and see who can come out on top. Chicago's first trip to the finals, a franchise record 61 wins, and they have stormed through the playoffs, going 14-2 thus far. I don't think there's any question about it. This is certainly the best Bulls team ever.
Passes to Teagle. Banked in off the glass.
Love the balance here. Not just falling in love with the three ball, inside and outside action.
Perkins against Grant. Left side, Jordan. Trying to get open is Pippen. Campbell grabs the board. And Mike, it looks like year 25 for the Bulls might just be their finest.
And you look at the ages of guys like Jordan, Pippen, Grant. This is a Bulls team poised for sustained excellence. Step one, closing out the Lakers.
And as you know, closeout games are always the most difficult. Divac has checked in for the Lakers. Will Perdue's checked in for Chicago. Hodges comes in for John Paxson. Lakers shooting their third and fourth free throw shots of the night. First one falls for him.
And what I appreciate about Divac is how clever he is. Not just a shrewd passer, but an intelligent scorer as well.
Mike, Chicago leading this series 3-1. A win away from an NBA title.
Michael Jordan so close to that elusive first ring. Winning it all would take MJ's career to another level.
Absolutely. Timeout called, the Lakers. We've seen Michael Jordan really having a great game.
He's really taking it to him inside. They got to find a way to slow him down.
.105 left now here in the second. Here's Teagle. He's guarded by Hodges. A crossover. Jump shot is good that time. Teagle's got his third basket of the night.
That is what you call a killer crossover.
Such a deadly move when done right.
Here's Jordan. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here. It's on Vlade Divac.
As a defender, you have to stay attached to Jordan. But here, he notices him playing tight and wisely draws the contact.
On the night, he's gone 2-for-2 at the stripe. Free throw good, Jordan. And he makes both free throws. There's 49 seconds left to play here in the half.
Growing up here in Inglewood, Eldon Campbell has to be on cloud nine playing in the finals. The rookie was the Lakers' first-round pick this season.
Magic is struggling. The Lakers need him to play better if they want to get this series back to Chicago.
Well, he's much better than that. Really, no excuse for missing that lane.
And Jordan is cooking here in the second. You can tell he wants to end this series.
Hey, the defense has the right idea there, but Jordan has the skills to overcome the contact.
And the call will be against Scottie Pippen. That's his first foul of the game, and the bonus will go to the free throw line. Los Angeles shooting their fifth and six free throws of the game. He doesn't get the second one. Chicago leading by 21, and it's Pippen in the corner. Back to Jordan. Perdue the pass to Hodges. From 13, that shot off. Michael Jordan getting it done for the Chicago Bulls. He totaled 14 points in the quarter. He's given them all the offense they need right now. We'll get right back. It is a spectacular early evening here in Southern California. This is Game 5 of the 1991 NBA Final. Second half here from Inglewood. The Lakers looking to extend the series. Chicago wants it to end.
Winning an NBA title is the final hurdle for Michael Jordan. He's won MVPs, scoring titles, even a Defensive Player of the Year award. But it's a team game, and winning this series is the last thing for Michael to accomplish.
So the Bulls five right now. Michael Jordan is out there with John Paxson. Then there's Grant. Then it's Cartwright. And it's Pippen in at the three spot. Here's Perkins. That's in there, Johnson with the assist.
I tell you what, the peripheral vision, the court awareness of Johnson, this guy always knows when one of his teammates is open.
And an NBA title, the only thing missing for the great Michael Jordan, Clark.
And Kevin, he's made some sacrifices, no doubt about it. As a young pro, I think sometimes Jordan tried to do it all himself. But MJ's game has continued to evolve, especially his passing. He's developed so much. Getting a ring is the final spoke in the wheel.
Here's Teagle. He has 7. Pocket 6. And it's Perkins with the jam. The Lakers are struggling with their shots tonight, but they just can't get into a groove.
Well, I think you've got to look at the opponent and give them some credit, you know. The duo of Pippen and Jordan, as good defensively as any in the NBA right now, and maybe in the history of the league when you think about it.
They've been terrific. Here's Johnson. He gets that one to drop. He's now 5-12.
Well, when you watch Magic Johnson play, you forget he's a 6'9 point guard. That size really helps him out.
Jordan passes to Curry. 2 points. That one goes. Cartwright's got 8 points.
And offensively, that's where Cartwright is at his best, working on the interior.
On the wing, Johnson. Defended by Jordan. Pass to Teagle. Devette's trying to free himself up. From outside, off the mark. Bulls leading by 23. Jordan is double. No good. So the Lakers will take it the other way.
While Michael Jordan gets the headlines, and deservedly so, Scottie Pippen is the glue of this team. Excellent defensively, a great passer. Pippen does it all.
A touch over 2.5 minutes of basketball played here in the third quarter. And here's Green. He'll bring it up for the Los Angeles Lakers. And Clark, when you think of Scottie Pippen, do you think he was an all-star snub this year?
Absolutely, Kevin. No question about it. I mean, he's the second best player on a 61-win team. I'm wondering how he didn't make it. I think we've seen Pippen make a statement during these playoffs. He's stuffing the stat sheet, averaging 21, 9 boards, and 6 assists. That's enough to stamp him as an elite player.
You make a great point.
Boy, that defense smothered him in there. Love the intensity.
Livingston's checked in for Carter.
Back to his second personal foul. Second team foul.
Here's Green. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. Devos. Oh, and the jam by Devos.
For 3 straight seasons in the playoffs, the Bulls were eliminated by the Pistons. But Chicago swept the Bad Boys to get here to this finals, slaying their dragon in the process.
Here's Livingston. Wants to get it to Jordan, and does. And they double up Jordan. And it's Pippen at the elbow. 6 on the shot clock. The Bulls need to get a shot off. No good from Paxson. And the Bulls eliminating the Pistons, Mike, the defending NBA champions, in the Eastern Conference Finals.
That Pistons series was a mental hurdle for the Bulls. Players telling me in previous years, the Pistons' mind games would get to Chicago. Not the case this time around. The Bulls maturing as a team.
Mentally strong for sure. And it's Green with the jam. This Bulls offense is running through Michael Jordan, Mike Fratello, piling up assists once again.
Phil Jackson wants Michael making the decision. The league MVP is so smart. Jordan is dictating this game.
Every facet of this game, you're right. Chicago making a switch here. I just checked in. Well, Mike, all series long, we've been monitoring the battle of MVP. Magic Johnson against Michael Jordan. And as we can see, Jordan with the advantage tonight.
And, Kev, it's been that way the entire finals. The Bulls have a 3-1 advantage. A huge reason is Michael has outperformed Magic.
Here's Livingston. Green with the rebound. Green's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. He's getting his first free throw attempt of the night right now. The first free throw is good.
The selfless, team-first attitude of Green is commendable. It's why his guys like playing with him.
Williams, he's checked in for Chicago. Stolen by Magic. Los Angeles, they have been coming through at the charity stripe. They've made 7 of their 8 attempts. That's good from Johnson. That's also good. So he hits both free throws.
This is what makes him tough. A big guy who can knock him down from the stripe.
And they double up Jordan.
Los Angeles.
Jordan finds Pippen. Williams trying to break free. 2 free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. This is his first free throw of the game. The first one falls. And both free throws good for Pippen. There's 53 seconds left in the third. For Los Angeles, they have gone 9 of 10 from the line, so making the most of their chances. First free throw is good.
And the energy Smith provides is important to this team. Someone you can expect to give his all out there.
Chicago leading by 13. It's stolen by Green. And this is his third trip to the line tonight. And he knocks down the first one.
You love the way Magic controls the pace of the game. He does it from start to finish.
And Johnson drops them both. This offense has been dynamic and diversified.
Everybody sharing the ball and sharing the load makes you really hard to defend. You got to have some guts and guile to take it to the bucket strong despite the big fella standing in the way.
That is good. And the Bulls lead is cut to just 11 on the basket from Smith.
It's all about agility for Smith inside. That's how he gets to a close range look.
Now 8 seconds separating the two clocks. Here's Livingston. And the layup's good off the glass. And the Bulls lead by 13.
Stay aggressive. I don't ever like to see teams pump the brakes when they've got the lead. Stay aggressive, attack, a fantastic way to pad your cushion.
Absolutely. You know a run is coming.
To the middle. It's stolen by Green. Smith wide open. He fired. And so it's the Chicago Bulls. 13 points up at the end of the period.
43.
And the fourth quarter from Inglewood. NBA Finals Game 5. Kevin Harlan joined by Mike Fratello, Clark Kellogg, and David Aldridge. Could this be the final period of hoops played this season?
Over the last 11 seasons, 5 titles for the Lakers, 9 trips to the NBA Finals. However, it feels like their time just might be up. LA has a roster that is getting older.
Perkins out there with D-Bots. Then it's Green, then it's Magic Johnson, and it's Smith in at the 2. That's who's in the game for the Lakers.
Good pass from the big man Green there. Recognized his teammate was open and got it to him.
Paxson kicks to Jordan. Back to Paxson. Shoots over Johnson. The assist numbers of Jordan in these finals has been outstanding, and he continues to share the rock. Feeds it to D-Box, to the paint. Here's Green. D-Box trying to free himself up. Green, no luck. And here's Jordan. He'll bring it up for the Bulls. Earlier, they held a 23-point lead. And there's the pass to Carter. That drops, and it comes off an assist from Jordan. Jordan's got his 9th assist in the game now. Lakers trail by 17. Clark, the state of this Lakers franchise. Will they be dominant, you think, this decade?
Kevin, it's going to be hard to sustain this level of excellence. I mean, Magic and Worthy getting older. This series, to me, feels like a changing of the guard in the midst.
Pippen misses. And here is Los Angeles now. Mike, what about these passing numbers of Michael Jordan? I mean, absolutely fantastic.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, Kevin. Michael is controlling the ball, controlling the game. Jordan's willingness to give up the rock. It is the big reason the Bulls are close to the title. Jordan has destroyed the Lakers passing. The rock in the finals. MJ showing he's become more than just a scorer.
On the wing, Johnson. Guarded by Jordan. Johnson kicks to Smith. 6 to shoot. And it's Perkins in the corner. The Lakers need to get a shot off here. And it's Green missing. Bulls leading by 15. From deep three-point range, it's hauled in by Los Angeles. Johnson's got his fifth rebound in this one. Smith, the pass to Perkins. To the inside, Divac. Some solid defense from Pippen. Well, the Bulls defense, Clark, has come to play again. Pippen and Jordan are relentless.
They sure are. Seems like they never get tired, Kevin. I mean, they work so hard on that end of the floor. They've stifled this talented Lakers attack.
We're in the final quarter of play here. 3 minutes in. Timeout called, the Lakers.
The interior defense has been very subpar, and I bet their coach is letting them know about it.
Allowing far too many points in the painted area. They need to put forth more of an effort defensively.
B.J. Armstrong's checked in for Carter. Pass to Johnson. Lots of room. And that one is good. Johnson's got 22 points.
And this team encourages Magic to look for a shot, especially from mid-range.
And another miss by Chicago.
Well, there wasn't much there in terms of defensive pressure. I'm sure he'd like another crack at that shot.
They kick it out to Green. Lakers working the ball around now. Johnson against Grant. Johnson, the pass to Perkins. Off target from outside.
And I have no idea how he clanked that one. The defense has to be thanking their lucky stars he didn't sink that one.
Lakers trail by 13. Trying to find a way out of this rut, Mike.
Yeah, looking to regain some momentum offensively.
Here's Johnson. Hits the jumper in space. Johnson's got 14 points now in the second half.
And when Magic has it going on, clear the way. He can dominate games all by himself. And it makes sense why they keep running the offense through him, proving how efficient he is.
Here are the Lakers. There's a minute 47 left in the fourth quarter of this one. Green in the post. He's against Jordan, and it's Green missing. Bulls leading by 13. Here's Paxson. Jordan left side. Pippen kicks to Grant. Here's the three. It's tipped. And it's out of bounds. They say it was last touched by Grant. We've got 1:23 left to play here in the fourth. Now Johnson for the three. It's hauled in by the Bulls. Jordan's got 5 rebounds tonight. And Jordan throws it down.
They've chosen not to let up at all. They continue to pile it on.
And I'll come out and say it. This game is all but over.
Smith sets the pick for Johnson. Fades away. And he comes up with the deuce.
Nice clean stroke on Magic's jumper there. You can tell he's got that shot locked in.
Outside Pippen. Pass to Armstrong. Pippen against Perkins. Over to the wing. Paxson passes to Jordan. That one falls, coming off of Paxson's feed. Jordan's got 40 points. Johnson down low, guarded by Jordan. Perkins kicks to Johnson. And here is Green. Pass to Perkins. And Jordan sends it back.
With an incredible 4-foot vertical leap and that 6'11 wingspan, it's tough to get a shot over Jordan.
Another one falls for Chicago.
They have shown up at just the right time, putting the finishing touches on this game.
This run absolutely closes the door on any chance of a surprise ending. That'll do it.
Michael Jordan and the Chicago Bulls have done it. For the first time, Mike Fratello, the Bulls are world champions.
Michael Jordan has answered the doubters. He can lead a team to a title. This has to be extra sweet for Mike.
And for the Bulls, Clark Kellogg, this is a long time coming.
Tremendous job by this entire organization.